Respected Chairperson, Madam Professor Gan, my esteemed co-panelists, erudite participants, invitees, ladies and gentlemen, and dear students. It is my pleasure and privilege to participate in this seminar on rural development. And yesterday and today, you have been listening to eminent scholars having the expertise in field work, working with different NGOs, and also academics. I had taught in the university system for 36 years in political science. When a politician speaks or a political scientist speaks, you take a different view. You hate politics, but you really love to listen to a politician or a political scientist. The focus today is rural development. And one of the sub-themes of this conference, rural development, is state intervention. In the intermediate class, we were told in political science, the state comes into existence for the bare needs of man and continues to exist for the sake of good life. So it is the state which concretely means government and its different agencies. In the realm of rural development, the role of civil society or NGO or any other organization is very limited. Because for rural development, you need massive investment. You see the rural development budget now, it is in terms of thousands of crores. So because of paucity of time, I'll speak within 10-12 minutes. My first thing is, what is the country? In the Constitution Article 1, we have mentioned India, that is Bharat, shall be a union of states. It was debated, why do you keep two names? No, the consensus was India is a modern name and Bharat is our old name, traditional name. Now also when we see India, we divide in terms of urban, rural. Say urban is India, rural is Bharat. We have 640,867 villages and 7,935 towns and urban centers. And when I say urban center, the definition is any composition of people having more than 5,000 is a town. So they are mostly peri-urban villages. City means, like we jocularly say, if you ask a man from Pune, what about your children, he will say, my eldest son is like this, my young son is like this, young son is like this. He will not tell you that my young son is 12 years old, reading in high school, this much. Young son is in the convent because he goes by 4 p.m. from Pune to Bombay, returns by night, only he has seen his children in sleeping position. That is urbanization. You stay in Ahmedabad 45 years, 45 miles away, but you are asked, you are in Ahmedabad? Huh? What is your distance to Gandhinagar? 45 minutes. That means one town to another in the same city. That is urbanization. New York is urban. Small towns are not urban. Secondly, so far as this term is concerned, rural refers to remote farming areas, urban refers to crowded cities. But rural-urban dichotomy has to be seen from its proper perspective. What is development? Development has been an important component of social science research or discourse for the last two centuries. Many nations after liberation movements, they have faced challenges, and there are two approaches. One is top-down approach, the other is bottom-up approach. We still remember Mahatma Gandhi, adding his name to Narega, having some scheme on Gandhi. But whatever Gandhi has said on rural development is still relevant. what is the opinion of Gandhi? Gandhi said, I quote, India's soul lives in villages. He also said, unless we construct, improve and develop villages, India will perish. Exploitation of villages compelled Gandhiji to remark that the blood of the village is the cement with which the edifice of the cities is built. I want this blend that is today infecting the arteries of the cities to run once again in the blood vessels of the village. The village is the fundamental unit of development of the country, state. An ideal village, according to Gandhiji, will contain intelligent human beings. They will not live in dirt and darkness as animals. Men and women will be free and able to solve their own against anyone in the world. There will be neither be plague, nor cholera, nor smallpox. No one will be idle. No one will wallow in luxury. Similar feelings are expressed by Vishwakavi Rabindranath Tagore when he remarked, the status of Mother India, that is the village, you have reduced to that of a maid servant due to draining of resources from the villages of cities. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, on 24th of August 1947, told the Constituent Assembly, I quote, the service of India means the service of the millions who suffer. It means ending of poverty and ignorance and disease and inequality of opportunities. The ambition of the greatest man of our generation, meaning Mahatma Gandhi, has to wipe out every tear from every eye. That may not be beyond us, but as long as there are tears and sufferings, so long as our work will not be over. So 47, 2016, the same challenge remains. Mahatma Gandhi talked about village republic, village development. Nehru had a model which believed in four institutions in a village. One cooperative, one school, one hospital, one panchayat. Still we are having that. So coming to the last part, because it's a very long paper, I don't want to spoil your time. What are the new initiatives taken? We have taken ample measures for rural development. If you count them down, there are hundreds. You cannot remember, only you can find in the books. The money that you have spent also on rural development is fabulous, but the impact is yet to be seen in its fullest form. So what are the new initiatives? We want electricity. We want strengthening service delivery system in rural areas. We want rural connectivity. Roads are the carriers of development. We need housing. And there is Indira Awas Yojana. There is a total sanitation program, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and adopting a village by a particular MP. We are having target to supply drinking water. We have many poverty reduction programs. We are also trying to extend or providing access to quality education at the elementary level and to reduce dropouts. We want affordable health care, rural health care, capacity building of the PRI functionaries, ensuring inclusive growth and promoting social justice, strengthening planning machinery at the bottom level, district level, sub-division level, substantially empowering the PRIs, devolution of powers and political parties from the people, women empowerment measures like allowing women to take decision for themselves and also to provide help through SSG and microfinance and capacity building. We have Food Security Act, streamlining public distribution system, public awareness, use of ICT, use of RTI Act, concept of social audits. But friends, as it is said, the same slogan continues, roti, kapda aur makan. So in conclusion, let me say, we have spent so much of rural development, but I was saying as a school student, operation was successful, but the patient died. We are seeing some changes in the road connectivity, in terms of power supply, but quality of life, dignity of life, curbing migration, forced migration, distance migration, giving them good drinking water, giving them help for agricultural development, giving help for convergence activities, and what to talk of Swachh Bharat. It is a great mission, We have different policies of the new government led by Modi. I have no time to analyze. I have jotted down all policies. What we need is, we need a mindset to help the rural people. Because we are all basically from rural areas. But once we have become urban, we don't care for the rural areas. Thank you very much.